DNA of our thinking, that, you know, Amma's golden word still rings in all our minds, that the very purpose of education is not only to grow the mind but also to expand the hearts. Value-based education is a very strong and integral component of our education. Holistic education is a very integral component of our education here. And we also believe strongly in the fact that we are not just here to mold the students for these 4 years. We are here to train them for a lifetime. Now, why I'm trying to emphasize this is we are very conscious about the discipline, because we feel that all the high-end technological inputs, unless it goes into the right mind, it's not going to benefit the society. Okay. In fact, it could become the other way around. It could do more harm than good. What we try to do is, through this value-based education, that's very subtly introduced to the heritage and the culture of our great nation and the best practices. And I think our faculty are role models. The way we interact with the students, the way we have a kind of personal bondage. What is more important is we have several committees. We have several opportunities for students to take leadership roles. In fact, all our events are actually driven by the students.
Okay.
And when you give those leadership roles, when you give them that kind of recognition, when you have that kind of bondage with the students, they would like to live up to that image. So that's been a formula that we have practiced, trying to give an identity to each student depending on their strength. Some are good in academics, some are good in lab work, someone is good at doing innovative projects, someone is good in singing, someone is good in painting, someone is good in organizing events. So we try to give the opportunity as it's fit for that particular student. And when we do that, a majority of students feel self-motivated, self-disciplined, and we feel that that's the way to build them for a lifetime. Beyond 4 years, we are not going to be there to guide them about what is right and wrong. So we are not going around with a stick. But at the same time, we do have very broad rules and regulations. We are very clear. When our student or our parents come and ask us about our rules and regulations, I have only one line to tell them in very simple words. You don't have to go and read through our rules and regulations. Whatever the student can do at home in front of their parents, they are most permitted, and they can do the same thing here. While we do have certain restrictions in their safety concerns and in an overall comfort of a community living in the campus, but they have all the freedom and fun to make campus life beautiful.
So what I understand from your discussion on discipline is that you don't enforce discipline, but make the students feel within themselves as to how important it is to be disciplined.
You would agree with me that that's the best way forward.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, you know, nobody like policing. I mean, nobody would like going behind the students and watching them as to what they're doing, but make them realize that this discipline, what you go through in the next 4 years of their professional life in Amada School of Engineering, Chennai, will lead them to better citizens of tomorrow. I think that is a wonderful way of disciplining the students by themselves, but not forcing them to follow this. That's excellent.